Hi students, good afternoon to all. I welcome you all in this fluid mechanics practical session. In today's practical session, we are going to conduct the practical number 5, calibration of an orifice. Okay, this is the practical that we will see in today's practical session. So what is an orifice? So that first we will understand, and then we will see other points related to this orifice. The title of this experiment will be calibration of an orifice, and aim is the to determine the hydraulic coefficients of orifice. Okay, so we can note down the title of this practical. Write down there practical number 5, then title, then aim of the practical. Note it down in your notebook. Title: calibration of an orifice. Aim: to determine hydraulic coefficients of orifice. Okay, it's over. Now, what is an orifice? So here you can see the definition of an orifice. Orifice is a small opening of any cross section, such as circular, triangular, rectangular, on a side or on the bottom of the tank through which the fluid flows. Okay, so here in this diagram you can see this is the tank. So orifice is nothing but it is an opening. It may be of circular in shape. That opening, it may be circular, it may be square, it may be rectangular in shape, it may be triangular in shape, okay, like this or like this. So such kind of opening, if it is there on the side of the tank or at the bottom of tank, such type of opening is called as orifice, okay, through which the fluid flows or the liquid flows. Such opening is called as orifice, okay. So depending upon the size, shapes of this particular opening, we have the different types of orifice, such as circular orifice, then square shape orifice, rectangular orifice, triangular orifice. Okay, so this is the classification of orifice. Again, depending upon the size of the orifice, we have the small size orifice and large orifice. These are the classification of orifice. Again, if the edge of the orifice is sharp, then it is called as the sharp orifice, and otherwise the bell shape orifice or bell mouth orifice is also another example of the orifice. Okay, now what is the meaning of calibration of an orifice? So calibration of orifice is nothing but determination of hydraulic coefficients of the orifice device. Whatever that device orifice is there, we need to find out the hydraulic coefficients of that particular orifice. That is the meaning of this calibration of an orifice. Okay, then question comes, what is the meaning of this hydraulic coefficients? Okay, so like we have determined the coefficient of discharge for an venturimeter. Okay, if you remember the last practical we have performed, the determination of CD, coefficient of discharge for an venturimeter, the title of that practical was calibration of venturimeter, right? So it was the calibration of venturimeter in which we determine the coefficient of discharge CD of that venturimeter in that particular practical. Similarly, in this particular practical, we are going to determine the hydraulic coefficients of orifice. Here, instead of finding just CD, here we are going to find out the three coefficients to which we call the hydraulic coefficients of orifice. And what are that various hydraulic coefficients of orifice? First one is the coefficient of velocity. In short, we call it as a CV. Then coefficient of contraction, we call it as a CC. And third hydraulic coefficient is the coefficient of discharge, which is nothing but it is also called as CD. Okay, so already you know how to find out the CD that we have determined. And what is the meaning of CD is known to, well known to you. Okay, so let us once again here now see in details what are the meaning of this different hydraulic coefficients. Okay, ya pratyekacha artha kay apan ya tikani samjun gya. The first of all comes the hydraulic the coefficient of velocity or CV. So this coefficient of velocity is nothing but it is also defined as the ratio between the actual velocity of the jet of the liquid at vena contracta and the theoretical velocity of the jet. Okay, now before understanding this definition we should understand the meaning of this word jet and vena contracta. Jet of liquid is nothing but it is the this particular jet, it is this flow is called as the jet of the liquid. Okay, je bahir padnare paanyacha jo flow ahe orifice madhun, that is called as the jet of the liquid. And then what is vena contracta? So see here, when the liquid flows through this any opening or the orifice, at that time it achieves some larger shape than the orifice. Orifice madhun jevas bahir padto tevas tacha jo aakar ahe, so it may be larger than the orifice, but it goes on decreasing. Okay, and it becomes smaller than the diameter of the orifice. Orifice cha diameter piksha to jo cross section hai, it becomes smaller. And one particular point, that cross section area of the jet, it becomes smallest. Okay, to saglyat tya tikani lahan hoto, and then gradually it will go on increasing. Okay, it increases gradually. So that point at which the cross section area of the jet is minimum, that point is called as the vena contracta. Okay, also one more characteristic of this vena contracta is that the streamlines at the vena contracta, all the streamlines at the vena contracta, they are parallel to each other. Okay, at other section section other than vena contracta, this jet, that streamlines, they will not be parallel to each other. They may be converging, they may be diverging, okay, but they will not be parallel to each other. So this is the point, vena contracta, at which these streamlines, they are parallel to each other. Okay, so this is the characteristics of this vena contracta. One first characteristics we have seen, that it has the smallest cross section area of the jet and the streamlines are parallel to each other at that particular section. One more thing of the vena contracta is that the size of this vena contracta, the distance, generally where this vena contracta form, it forms at the distance which is equal to half the diameter of the orifice. Ha jo orifice asto yache orifice chi diameter hai, the diameter cha half jevda distance asel, or we can say the radius, at the distance of the radius of the orifice, at that distance generally this vena contracta appears or it forms. Okay, so this terms we have now understood what is the meaning of jet of the liquid and what is the meaning of vena contracta. So let us understand again the meaning of this word coefficient of velocity. So it is defined as the ratio between actual velocity to the actual velocity of jet at vena contracta and the theoretical velocity of jet. Just we have defined the CD, coefficient of discharge, we have defined for the venturi meter. Similarly, what was the definition for the CD? It was the ratio of actual discharge to the theoretical discharge, right? This actual discharge, it always less than the theoretical discharge, because actually when the liquid flows through any particular system, the loss of head, it occurs there, and because of that head loss, the whatever the discharge we get, it is always less than the theoretical discharge. Okay, similarly there is another term, actual velocity and theoretical velocity. The actual velocity is the velocity actually which is flowing, the velocity of that particles which are actually flowing in that jet. That velocity at vena contracta is called as the actual velocity, which can be denoted by letter va. And the theoretical velocity is the velocity of the fluid which is obtained by mathematical expression. Okay, under root of 2gh, je mathematical expression cha vapar karun apan je tya tikani velocity find out karto, that velocity is called as a theoretical velocity. Okay, this is the theoretical velocity, means it will always be greater than the actual velocity, because whenever the liquid flows through any system at that time, the loss of heat it is going to occur, and the difference between this theoretical and actual velocity, it will not be that much bigger, larger, because the loss of heat will be very small, but it will be there, and due to which the actual velocity will be always less than the theoretical velocity. And the mathematically, we can express this coefficient of velocity as the actual velocity of the jet at vena contracta divided by theoretical velocity, or also we can write mathematical expression for CV as CV is equal to V. This V also can be written as V actual divided by theoretical velocity is obtained by the formula under root of 2G capital H. Okay, so V theoretical we can write like this. Okay, V theoretical is nothing but it is under root of 2GH. So here you can write this expression for this CV as V actual upon V theoretical, or you can write the expression as VA, that is V actual upon under root of 2G capital H. Now, what is this capital H? This capital H is nothing but it is the head of the water or head of the liquid above the center of this orifice. Orifice is a center. A center pasun kiti height varti the liquid surface hai, to kiti height varti. So this distance from the center of the orifice is called as this head, or it is written as capital H. Okay, so depending upon this head, this velocity it will vary. If the head is larger, then definitely the theoretical velocity will also increase. Okay, as well as actual velocity is also going to increase. Okay, in proportion. And if the head becomes smaller, then this total velocity will become smaller, because they are directly proportional to each other. Okay, then according to the theory part, what should be the ratio, or what should be the value of this coefficient of velocity? Hi, value kiti asala paye. Then as per the theory, the value of CV, it should lies between 0.95 to the 0.99. okay, ha range madhe CV chi value asala paye. The orifice may be of any shape, the value of CV it should varies between this range 0.95 to 0.99. okay, and common value generally it is taken at 0.98. okay, for the sharp edged orifice. Sharp edge means the orifice which has the sharp edge. Okay, this is the tank, and here the edge of the orifice is sharp, so this type of orifice is called as the sharp edge. And for the sharp edge, generally the value of CV it can be taken at 0.98. okay, so in your if examination it is of the MCQ type, in that MCQ type examination such kinds of question it may be asked, or in your practical oral examination this question may be asked to you. Define what is orifice, then tell what is the coefficient of velocity, tell me the range of the CV value for the orifice. So all these values and then definition formulas, it should be by hearted by all the students, remembered by all the students. Okay, so in your notebook you can write down this three hydraulic coefficient first, then write down the title coefficient of velocity, then write down this formula, and then write down this value in your notebook. Okay, do it fast. As theory part we have not yet covered, so it is important to note it down, all the things here. Write on the title hydraulic coefficients, and then below that mention the three types: coefficient of velocity, then coefficient of contraction, and coefficient of discharge. Then also you can draw this small diagram in your notebook where you can show the head of the liquid above the orifice, and then you can show the vena contracta, you can show the jet of liquid, and then write on the title coefficient of velocity CV. You can note down the definition for it. and write down the mathematical expression for CV. CV is equal to V actual velocity divided by theoretical velocity. Okay, or you can also write this as V actual divided by under root of 2G capital H. Okay, do it first. Is it over? Yes. Write down this value also. The range of CV 0.95 to 0.99. Do it fast, otherwise we may have the very less time to perform the practical. Is it over? Okay, now let us move ahead. There is a problem. Yes, I have given the access to unmute yourself now. It was in setting, it was selected as the mute all. So now you can unmute yourself and tell your query. See, attendance is very low, only 35 students are it joined. So all the students should be very serious regarding at least practicals, because you have the practical oral examination, and if you don't give the right answer, proper answers in the oral examination, there is a chance that your oral examination, it may remain back. Okay, you may fail in the oral examination. The practical oral examination, it has the separate passing head, and you may fill in that. Okay. Are you getting some disturbance? Are you getting some noise?
No, sir.
Yes. Tumhara noise itla ka aitu the ka awaz bahar tisra kay
nahi it's
nahi na okay
was here in one of the lab, some vibrator, I think it is, it has been started. You know, vibration. That noise is coming to me, but you may not be able to listen because of the frequency of the that particular machine is different. Okay. Let us see now the second hydraulic coefficient of contraction. So right on there, in your notebook. What is coefficient of contraction? So coefficient of contraction, it is defined as the ratio of the area of the Z actor, the contractor, to the area of orifice, and it is denoted by letter CC. Okay. Now, I have already told you that the area at the vena contracta, cross section area at the vena contracta, is very small as compared to the area of the Z, area of the orifice. Okay. So here, the coefficient of contraction is nothing but it is the cross section area of this Z and divided by cross section area of the orifice. Okay, so that is the formula. You can see here CC is equal to area of the Z at the vena contracta divided by area of the orifice. Okay, so mathematically it can be written as CC is equal to AC upon capital A. So note it down in your notebook. The value of CC varies from 0.61 to 0.69 depending upon the shape and size of the orifice. So it may vary from 0.61 to 0.69. In general, the values for the CC is taken at 0.64. Okay, so note it down in your notebook. Is it over? Then comes the coefficient of discharge. This coefficient of discharge is well known to you as we have performed the practical on it. The definition of the coefficient of discharge is same for this orifice also. It is defined as the ratio of the actual discharge from an orifice to the theoretical discharge from the orifice. Okay. But here, the formula for finding the theoretical discharge, it will be different as the formula that we have used for finding the theoretical discharge in the venturimeter. Okay. The formula for that will be different. But the formula for finding the actual discharge, it will be same as that we have obtained, that we have used in the venturimeter practical. Okay, so here CD is nothing but it is, we can write it as Q actual divided by Q theoretical. Okay, now here this theoretical actual discharge, how we have measured this? There we found what is the volume of water collected in the measuring tank, and with a stopwatch we find how much time it is taking for filling some amount of water in that tank, and with the help of that we find the actual discharge, right? The same procedure we are going to use here for finding the actual discharge. Then how to find out the theoretical discharge? This theoretical discharge, it can be obtained by using the formula. We know that just before two lectures we have studied that discharge, it can be obtained by multiply the cross section area with the velocity, right? We have used this formula for solving the problem also. The same formula can be used here to find out the theoretical discharge of the orifice. The cross section area of the orifice, capital small a, multiplied by theoretical velocity, you will get here the theoretical discharge of the bench of this orifice. Okay, or you can write this formula also like this, capital small a multiplied by under root of 2g capital H, right? Where this capital H is nothing but it is the head of water or head of the liquid above the center of the orifice, right? Also, again, if you want to simplify it, this A, it can be written as, if the circular cross section area is there, we can write here pi by 4 into d square into under root of 2gh. Okay. So likewise, we can find by using this formula, what is the Q theoretical or theoretical discharge it can be obtained. Actual discharge we can obtain by using this particular method. And if you divide this actual discharge by the theoretical discharge, then you will get the coefficient of discharge or CD for this orifice. Okay. Now, if you look at this particular formula, now here I will tell you what the relation between the CD, CC and CV. In theory also we are going to see that. In short, here I will tell you. This actual discharge, it can be written as actual velocity into theoretical, actual velocity into actual area. And this theoretical discharge, it can be written as theoretical velocity into theoretical area. Okay. Now this actual velocity upon theoretical velocity is nothing but it is CV. And this actual area upon theoretical area is nothing but it is CC. So here we can write the relation between this CD, CC and CV as CD is equal to CV into CC. Okay. Take relation of between these three hydraulic coefficient. The coefficient of discharge is equal to coefficient of velocity multiplied by coefficient of contraction. Okay. Then what is the range of this value for CD of the orifice? It varies from 0.61 to 0.65. Okay. And what was the range for the CC? It was 0.61 to 0.69. Here the range is 0.61 to 0.65. Okay. And general value 0.62, it can be taken for this CD. Okay. So you can note down this definition. You can note down the formula. CD is equal to actual upon Q theoretical. It can be written as Q actual upon A into under root of 2GH. And in this practical, we are going to utilize this particular relation to find out the coefficient of contraction. Okay, here cardinality upon a relation upon our own. If I write CC, if I take this CV on other side, LHS side, then I can get here the CD upon CV. This formula I will get. Means to find out, if you want to find out CC, if you know the value of CD and the value of CV, then you can easily find out what is the value of CC. Okay. So in this practical, first we will find out what is the value of CD. Then we will find out what is the value of CV. And from these two values, we will find out the value of CC by dividing CD by CV. Okay. In this way, we will get the value of CC. Now, because it is difficult to get the value of this actual, the area of vena contracta, because it is the Z, and how to find out the diameter of the Z, it is the question. And this area of the orifice, it can be obtained as orifice, it has the standard diameter, and from that diameter, we can find out the area of the orifice. But it is difficult to find out the area of the Z at the vena contracta. Okay, so by using the indirect method, we find the value of CC by using this formula. CC is equal to CD upon CV. Okay, this formula we are going to use to find out the coefficient of contraction. Right, so is it over? Yes, anyone?
Oh, sir.
Okay. Now you can see this is the experimental setup that we are going to utilize use for performing this particular practical calibration of orifice. Okay, this is the tank, and this tank is attached with here small orifice which will be attached on this side. This is the piezometric tube that we are going to use to find out what is the head of water above the orifice, center line of the orifice. So this H, to measure this H, we are going to take the help of this piezometric tube. Okay. Then we are going to measure the actual discharge, that is Q actual. We are going to measure the Q actual with the help of this measuring tank. Okay. We will close this valve and we will measure the time required
to rise the water level here, let us say 50 mm, to rise this water level 50 mm, how much time it has been taken, that we'll find out. Then we multiply this 50 mm by the cross section area of the tank to get the volume of water collected in the tank. And if you divide this volume of water by the time, then you will get the discharge, actual discharge going through this. Okay, and once you get this reading, you can open this valve and this water will flow back to this here. So here, with the help of this tank, here we are going to find out what is the value of Q actual. Okay, Q theoretical, how we are going to find out? Here, with the help of this tank, you will find the value of capital H. ओके या ठिकाणचा जो हेड आहे त्याला आपण नोटेशन वापरतोय कॅपिटल एच, आणि या ठिकाणचा जो हेड आहे त्यासाठी आपण स्मॉल एच हे नोटेशन वापरतोय. कीप दिस इन माइंड. ओके, हे आपल्याला कॅपिटल एच या ठिकाणी भेटला भेटेल. सो विथ हेल्प ऑफ दिस व्हॅल्यू वी कॅन फाइंड आउट व्हॉट इज द क्यू थेरॉटिकल. जस्ट नाउ वी हॅव रिटन द फॉर्म्युला फॉर द क्यू थेरॉटिकल एज ए मल्टीप्लाइड बाय अंडर रूट ऑफ 2gh, राइट. So this put, we will put this head here in this equation, and this A is nothing but it is the area of orifice. In observation, you will get the diameter of the orifice, and from that you can find out what is the area of orifice. After putting this value, you will get the theoretical discharge. And once you get the theoretical discharge, now it is quite easy for you to find out what is the CD, Q actual divided by Q theoretical. By using this formula, you can find out the CD, right? Then how to find out the CV? Okay, to find out the CV, there is another formula. Practical formula is a different formula. Theory मध्ये आपण जो formula पाहिला या ठिकाणी V actual upon V theoretical. This is the formula in the theory that we use. But theoretical velocity is very easy to find out. With the help of this H height, we can find out the theoretical velocity that is directly under root of 2gh by using this formula. But actual velocity, finding this actual velocity is difficult because the z is flowing like this, and how to find the velocity of this z, actual velocity of this z. So for this reason, the scientists have adopted alternate method to find this actual velocity, and that formula for finding the actual velocity is x divided by under root of 4hy. This is the formula that is used to find out the theoretical this actual velocity. So we will see now on the next line the observations, different types of observation which are required to perform this practical, and then we will see the calculations. In that calculation, you will note down all the formulas that are required for this. So this is the observation and observation table to perform this practical. Okay, so first of all, write down in your notebook observations. Observation asa lihat ya dikani, and below that write down these observations, first, second, third and fourth. First observation, shape of the orifice. In our FM lab, we have the circular kind of orifice, we have the triangular. But here on this particular device, it is attached, the orifice is of the circular shape. The shape of the orifice, you can write it as a circular. Then what is the diameter of that orifice? It is 15 mm, or we can write in meter as 0.015 meter. Then area of orifice, you can find out the area of orifice from this diameter of the orifice, and it is 1.767 × 10⁻⁴ m². Then next observation is the area of collecting tank or measuring tank. So it is has the dimensions of 0.33 multiplied by 0.413 meter, or 33, it is in meter, okay, 33 cm by 41.3 cm, and in meter it is 0.33 × 0.413. If you make it products, then you will get the cross section area of the collecting tank at 0.135 m². Okay. And next is the observation table. Prepare the observation table here like this. Number of columns are here 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you can prepare the table in a vertical manner in your notebook. If horizontally, if it doesn't fit there in your notebook, then you can make it vertical. Okay, are you getting what I'm saying? See here, हे तुमची अशी नोटबुक आहे. या नोटबुक मध्ये असा जर टेबल बसत नसेल तर तुम्ही टेबल असा तयार करा त्या ठिकाणी उभा. ठीक आहे, सो इन फर्स्ट कॉलम देर इज सिरियल नंबर 1, 2, 3. देन सेकंड कॉलम हेड अबो द ओरिफिस, दॅट इज कॅपिटल एच इन मीटर. In third column, there is a rise of water in the major tank, small h, in meter. Next column is about the volume of water collected, V, in meter cube. Then next column, time required, capital T, in second. The second last column is about the X, and last column is about Y. So what is this X and Y that I will tell you here? It has been shown in this particular diagram. In this diagram, you can observe, you can see here, this is the tank, and this is the center line of the orifice. This is the head above the orifice, depth of the water above the orifice. And this X is nothing but, it is the distance of any particular point from the vena contracta. Okay, this point C, CC is nothing but, it is the vena contracta. Okay, if you visually observe there, you will not be able to see the vena contracta easily because water is transparent, and there the cross section area, minimum cross section area to observe it, it's somewhat very difficult task here. So for this reason, because this jet is of having very small diameter, and in that to detect that particular vena contracta, it is difficult. So here, as we have I have told you that the location of this vena contracta, it is at the half of the diameter of the orifice. So we can easily, we can locate that with this particular formula. Okay, 0.5D. So that from that position of the vena contracta, the position of any point on the Z surface, at Z surface varti ekada kutlahi point ghyaycha, tyachi ji position ahe, this value we are going to measure with the help of scale. Okay, scale cha sahayane apan ya thikani x value tya thikani measure karto, and there is a one arrangement here, one horizontal scale is attached, rod is there, and to this one pointer, vertical pointer is attached. Okay, in some of the experimental setup there is a pointer gauge, or there is hook gauge also there. Hook gauge manje asa type cha ek hook gauge asto kahi practical setup madhe. This hook gauge is provided so that we can take we can attach this particular point at the bottom of the Z. Okay, at bottom cha apan ya thikani reading ghu shakto, manje ha x and y, so bottom cha apan ya thikani find out. In our lab, whatever the hook gauge is there, it is of the pointer gauge type. Hook gauge is, pointer type gauge is there, so we cannot find what is the position of this lower profile, lower khalcha profile aplyala ya thikani yacha point select nahi karta yenar. So we will select the point or the upper profile, how varcha jo surface ahe yachyavarti ekada point apan select karun tyachi position from this particular point we are going to measure. This is the horizontal x value, means what is the distance of this point P from the vena contracta, and vertical distance will be a horizontal line. If you draw this horizontal line from this particular center of orifice, and then from this at first depth this particular point is located, that will give you the value of y. Okay, and once you get this x and y value, you note it down here, and afterwards you can put these values in the formula to get the value of CV, coefficient of velocity. Okay, I think everyone has noted down this table also. Is there any one who remained to draw this table? If it is over, then I can proceed to the next slide.
Over, sir.
Over. Okay. Next part is the calculation. So these are the various formulas that we are going to use to find out these hydraulic coefficients. So one by one, you note down all these formulas in your notebook. First formula is for finding the actual discharge. So write down the formula. Q actual is equal to area of the cross section area of the tank multiplied by small h, that is rise of water in the tank, divided by t, that is time required to rise that height, which is measured in meter cube per second. Second formula is for the theoretical discharge. Q theoretical is equal to small a into under root of 2gh. And what is small a? Small a, already in observation you have noted down, small a is the area of the orifice, 1.76 into 10 to the power minus 4. That value we have to put it here. And under root of 2gh, where g is acceleration due to gravity, 9.81 meter per second square. And this capital H is nothing but it is the head of the liquid or head of the water above the center line of the orifice, right? Then third point, coefficient of discharge. Coefficient of discharge is obtained by using formula CD is equal to Q actual upon Q theoretical. So already here we have in step number one and step number two, or the formula number one and two, we have obtained the Q actual and Q theoretical. Just we have put these values here in this formula to get the coefficient of discharge, right? Next is the formula number four, coefficient of velocity, CV. And we have written their formula for the CV, actual velocity divided by theoretical velocity. And this is the formula that we are using to find out the CV in the practical. Okay, so it is written here, under root of x square upon under root of 4hy divided by 4hy. So I have written that formula like this, x upon under root of 4yh. So you can write like this also, because if you separate this square bracket here for this numerator and denominator, you can write this formula like this also. And last formula, how to find out the CV, CC. Once you get the value of CD and CV, with the help of this formula, you can find out the value of CC, coefficient of contraction. Is it work?
Oh, awesome.
Next point is result table. So prepare another table for results. In observation table, if you have drawn the observation table vertically, and if there is a space remain there, you can prepare the observation table, this result table there also. Okay, this is your page of notebook, and if you have written vertically, if you have drawn the observation table, and if there is a space, you can draw the result table there on that particular same page only, but mention here result table title. Okay, if the space is not there, you can on the new page, you can draw this table, the result table. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 columns are there. Okay, and 4 rows are there. First column is for the serial number, second for the theoretical discharge, next actual discharge, then CD, and then comes the average CD, then comes the CV, average CV, and then comes the CC and average CC. This is the observation table. Is it over?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then next point is about the conclusion. So here we can write the conclusion. The average value of hydraulic coefficients of orifice are, first, coefficient of discharge, coefficient of velocity, then coefficient of contraction equal to. whatever the average value you get in the result table, you can put that values here. Is it work? Yes.
Over.
Okay. Now, here we are going to work from the practical. Okay. But before that, you should understand what is the procedure that we are going to follow. Okay. You can see here, this is the particular diagram on which I am going to show you the steps that we are going to perform. We are going to start the pump. After starting the pump, water will start to flow inside this particular tank. And to avoid the drainage of this tank, there is a wall is provided here. We will close this wall so that water can rise inside this particular tank. Water will go on rising and it will start to flow through this particular orifice. Okay. And we have to define at how much head we have to provide here. Okay. And after reaching water at that particular head, for example, say 150 mm, एवढा जर आपण हेड या ठिकाणी ठेवत असेल तर या ठिकाणी जो स्केल प्रोव्हाइड केलेला आहे, जो या ठिकाणी पिझोमीटर बसवलेला आहे, त्या पिझोमीटरच्या साईडला जो स्केल आहे, त्या स्केलवरती आपण ते रिडिंग आल्यानंतर, त्या रिडिंगला वॉटर लेवल आल्यानंतर व्हॉट वी हॅव टू डू, वी हॅव टू ऍडजस्ट दिस पर्टिक्युलर वॉल अँड the return valve of the pump in such a way that the water level will be maintained inside this particular tank. Okay, the water level apply ya tikani maintain karayche, then only we can measure the actual discharge, theoretical discharge for this. If this level is fluctuating, then there is no use, because the calculations calculation will show the errors. Okay, there are technical errors this thing. So we have to make this water level stable. After making this water level stable, just we have to first note down this reading. Let us say it is 150 mm, then we have to put that value in this particular this column, reading number 1. Then here you can directly measure the actual discharge. You can go for measuring the discharge, or you can go for measuring this x and y value. Okay, let us say if we measure the discharge first here, then what we have to do, we have to close this particular wall, the discharge valve for this particular measuring tank. After closing this, here predetermined level of the water level, say 10 mm, it will be the start point, and let us say 60 mm is the stop point. So to rise this water level from 10 to 50, 60 means 50 mm water level, how much time it has taken, that we will measure in the stopwatch, right? So here, this is the second observation. This is the first observation. Second observation is the to rise the water level by 50 mm or any value, 30 mm, 20 mm, how much time it has taken, that time you are going to note down here. You will write down that particular rise in water level. Let us say it is 50 mm. So for 50 mm water level, how much time it has taken, that time you will note it down here. Okay, so here you have to write down this value in meter. So you can write it as a 0.050. okay, so this value can mention here 0.050. Then we have to find out the volume. This calculation part we can do it later on. By how we can find out this volume, already cross section area of the tank, it is given here. This is the area of the collecting tank. This cross section area multiplied by this rise in water level, you get the volume. This volume divided by time, you will get the discharge, right? So this was the second observation that you have done. Third observation, here we have to measure the x and y value. Okay, x value generally you can keep it constant. Okay, for this particular height, let us say we have taken this value of x as a 20 cm. Okay, 20 cm hi apan value ghetle asel. At this particular 10 cm, how much what is the depth y? This y is going to vary. For you can write here 0.2 as the 20 cm this x value, and for this 0.2, what is the depth of this y, this particular point, this pointer we have to attach or just touch this pointer to the surface of the liquid, Z liquid here, and you will get the value of Y here. Okay, ह्या पॉइंट पासून किती व्हॅल्यू आलेली आहे. इनिशियली व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, जो पॉइंटर आहे तो पॉइंटर आपण या ठिकाणी ठेवल्यानंतर किती व्हॅल्यू दाखवते वायची, ते आपण दॅट विल बी वाय वन व्हॅल्यू आपण त्या ठिकाणी नोट डन करूया. त्याच्यानंतर पॉइंटर इथं आल्यानंतर या ठिकाणी वायची व्हॅल्यू किती दाखवते, दॅट विल बी व्हॅल्यू वाय टू. सो वाय टू मायनस वाय वन हे केल्यानंतर आपल्याला ऍक्च्युअल वायची व्हॅल्यू या ठिकाणी भेटून जाईल, अँड दॅट व्हॅल्यू वी विल नोट इट डाऊन इन मीटर. ओके, then next step for the second run, what we are going to do for the second run, we will change the this particular head of the water. Let us say initially it was 150, now we will take it as a 180. 150 hota parat 180 apan ghetla, mag 180 ghetlyanantar parat ya tikani discharge kiti ala, ek pahila reading ya tikani lila 180, parat discharge reading apan ya tikani ghetla, ani nantar x he apan ya tikani fix thevle, x apan ya tikani badalle nahi, it was a 0.2. So I will take this 0.2 as the same x value, and I will now check what is the change in the y, whether it has increased or decreased. Okay, so accordingly this value. Okay, and then third reading comes. In the third reading again we will change this head in the tank. You can take it as a less than 180, 150, you can take it as a 120, let us say. Okay, then for this particular reading, what is the value of discharge, then what is the value of x and y, so that values we will note it down in this observation table. And once you observe all these values have been written here, you can find out what is the actual discharge, then you can measure what is the theoretical discharge with this formulas, and you can mention in the result table the theoretical discharge, actual discharge, then you can find out the cd, okay, and then cv. नेक्स्ट लगेच त्या ठिकाणी सीव्ही काढून घ्यायचा बाय युझिंग दिस फॉर्म्युला. सीव्ही इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वेअर अपॉन फोर वाय एच. बाय युझिंग दिस फॉर्म्युला यू कॅन व्हॉट एव्हर द ऑब्झर्वेशन यू हॅव गेट हिअर फॉर द एक्स अँड वाय, पुट दॅट व्हॅल्यूज इन दिस फॉर्म्युला अँड यू विल गेट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ सीव्ही. अँड देन हाऊ टू फाइंड आउट द सी सी, जस्ट यू हॅव टू डिवाइड द सी डी बाय सी व्ही टू गेट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ सी सी, राईट. सो yes, what has happened, yes, this is the formula CV, CC is equal to CD by CV. Use this formula to find out the value of CC and put this here. So do the same calculation for the remaining two readings and find out the average value of CD, average CC and average CV, and you can mention here the results whatever you have got here in the result table and in the conclusion. Okay, so this was about the theory about this practical. Now let us perform this practical, actual practical. Already I have not told you the procedure how to perform this, so to do that I need to start the video on my phone. I need to start the session on my phone, then only it is possible for you to show the practical. Now I will make it off here, the session. Okay.